Hello. Welcome to Lenze training. This tutorial shows how to optimize the speed control loop and position control loop in motor control by using slider and how to evaluate the drive behavior by signal recording, for example with the internal oscilloscope. We are working with the easy starter. The rotary axis is selected in the device list. Click on settings and select the option motor control under basic setup. To optimize the drive behavior, it is assumed that the rated data of motor are set correctly. We have already set the motor data from the Lenze C86 code as shown in the previous tutorials. Well, hopefully, you can remember that. The speed controller is automatically set when the motor has been selected from the motor catalog. If no mass inertia of the load is known or set, the automatically calculated settings for the speed controller enable optimum control behavior with an idle motor. In addition, we have a position controller in the servo control, which must be observed when optimizing the drive behavior. What is the most suitable way to adapt the controllers to typical load requirements? What should we keep in mind? In practice, the Ziegler and Nichols adjustment strategy is recommended to optimize the controller settings for speed and position control loops. Ziegler and Nichols determination means that the controller gain is increased until the stability limit of the control loop is reached. Then the gain is reduced by approximate factor 2 of this determined value. Using the controller settings determined in this way, the best possible dynamic drive behavior for real machine operation can be achieved, especially with respect to stability, following error characteristics, position accuracy and behavior when reaching the target position. The challenge is to adjust both controllers optimally at the same time, speed control loop and position control loop. For the adjustment of the most important controller parameter, the gain, we can use the slider control. By moving the slider to the right, an additional load is added to the motor inertia. For each load mass inertia, the required gain of speed controller and position controller is automatically suggested. The suggested values can be triggered via the button or immediately accepted and tested. In addition, the state of stability is marked for enabled controller. Let us look at the behavior. We start the drive with the internal controls. Enable operation. Jog positive. The drive moves at the set jog speed of 60 RPMs. The stability indicator shows stable behavior. We move the slider to the right, and nothing happens. The suggested values are only accepted in the controller by the confirm button. Let us switch to immediate takeover and move the slider further to the right. The suggested values are now activated without confirmation. Moving the slider further to the right, we reach the stability limit. In the stability indicator, the unstable state is shown immediately. We move the slider back approximately to the half distance and get the optimal settings for a stable and dynamic operation. If you know the load mass inertia of the machine, you can use the Set More Detailed Information button to directly enter the physical values for calculation. For detailed input, not only the rigid coupling but also the elastic coupling of the load is considered. In this case, it is necessary to specify the mechanical natural frequency. The optimal reset time of the speed controller is primarily dependent on the filter time of the actual speed feedback. The preset value of 0.3 milliseconds applies to high-resolution encoder systems such as resolvers or SIN-COS encoders. Any change in the actual speed filter time is automatically considered when calculating the speed controller reset time. Next, we will look at the changed drive characteristics using the oscilloscope. Let us record relevant motor control signals and evaluate the drive behavior during a drive stop. In comparison to the trend function, which is better suited for logging continuous processes, the oscilloscope is designed for recording highly dynamic processes. For this reason, we will use the oscilloscope function, which is operated via the oscilloscope tab. Configuring and starting the recording is only possible when an online connection to the inverter has been established. After the measurement is completed, the measured data in the inverter is transmitted and represented graphically on this oscilloscope user interface. The oscilloscope has 8 channels. First, we will add the variables for our recording. Double-click the name column in the channel list field to open the signal source selection dialog box. Select the parameters to be recorded in the dialog box or enter the parameter number or parameter name if known. In our example, we are looking for a variable that represents the speed set point, so we enter speed as filter criteria. Okay, so what we see is a lot of choices here. However, what is the relevant variable for us? Here we have several possibilities. First, we go into the signal flow and keep the relevant parameter numbers in mind. For example, we want to record the speed reference value at the input of the motor control, here called offset speed. We remember the parameter 0x60b1. Let us put the variable on the oscilloscope. Right mouse button for selection works alternatively to double click. 60b1, I hope we remembered. Press the OK button. This closes the dialog box, and the selection is accepted. Another way to select variables is to import prepared settings. The import function is in the right-hand settings area. By selecting the From File option, all settings can be easily imported from a provided template file. The configuration templates for the i950 inverter can be found on the Lenze website in the knowledge base. We choose the template drive performance for our oscilloscope recording. Afterwards, we can adapt the pre-selected variables to our requirements. For example, unused channels can be switched off or completely removed from the channel list. In our case, we want to record the measurement at the time the drive stops or comes to a standstill. Therefore, we select the channel showing the speed as signal source of the trigger. In our sample channel 4 feet, the offset speed. OK. Set the threshold value to 10 RPM. Choose falling edge. Let us set the delay time to minus 50%. A negative delay time activates a pre-trigger. Minus 50% means that half of the time axis of the measurement is before the trigger event, the other half is after the trigger event. The scan determines the window of the recording. The measurement duration is 10 times the time base. In our case, the drive is stopped within few hundred milliseconds. A time base of 100 milliseconds means that the measurement takes 1 second in total. This time fits perfectly with our stop event that we want to record. Now we will jog the drive manually. Let us go to the settings of manual jog to adjust the profile parameter for our measurement. Increase the jog velocity to 3600 units per second. Set the value of the deceleration time to 5 times of the velocity. This means the resulting deceleration time is a fifth of a second, or 200 milliseconds. Select the interface. Activate the internal control, enable the drive, and select jog positive. Go to the oscilloscope and click on start recording. The measurement is running. Stop the drive. Go back to the oscilloscope. Accept the note and upload the oscillogram from the device. For the first view, it is helpful to use the auto scale function. We activate the checkbox in the column AS and use the oscilloscope toolbar. Click on Scale Curve Automatically button or use the pull down option Set All Y Position to 0 level. Let us use the zoom function to display the curves more clearly. If necessary, we can zoom out using the right mouse button. Or move the Y axis or time axis while holding down the mouse button. What do we see now? The blue curves represent the start point and actual speed and ramp down from 600 RPMs to standstill. The following error between start point and actual value, the brown curve, increases briefly to approximate 200 position units during the dynamic deceleration process. This corresponds to approximate 1 degree difference at the motor shaft. Now we will change the slider to validate the result. Click on Settings tab and select Motor Control Parameter Dialog. Now move the slider to roughly the position we had previously determined using the Ziegler and Nichols method. Let us repeat the measurement. Go back to the oscilloscope and start recording. Start the jog mode. Download the oscilloscope. We immediately see the influence of the controller parameter change on the drive behavior. The following error is reduced to a part of the previous value. In summary, we can optimize the drive behavior with the help of the slider and the oscilloscope.